I'm Maria Menounos, and you're tuned in to AfterBuzz TV, the ESPN of TV talk. Now, let the buzz begin.
Welcome back.
Hi, guys.
I've been waiting for the beat to drop like, wait, okay, let me get in there.
Nice harmony, Alexis.
Thank you. I practiced.
Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of Love After Lockup here at AfterBuzz TV. I'm your host, Brianna Cheyenne. So glad for you to be back with us.
Back at it again.
We got a crazy episode to discuss. And luckily, I have the help of my amazing panel, like Miss Kittie Kaboom, who comes with the dumb criminals
yes,
all the time.
Yes, indeed. This is what I provide. What up, y'all? How
yes.
you?
Yes. And then we have Alexis Brown.
Hi, guys.
Always with the news and gossip.
Yes. Always in your business.
Always business and nosy. So what did you guys think about the episode?
Honestly, I feel like this episode was a setup, and I hate the setups. Like, I want to see
like
all...
Like, it was fake?
No. But just, like, it's setting us up for the next episode. Like, that's going to be the real funky breakdown. Like, this is a precipice. Is that the word?
Precipice.
Yeah, thank you. I feel like this is a precipice to next week, which I just, you know, I ain't got patience for that. Like, I want to see it all now. So, I enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. It was definitely good. Some of it better than others. But I really like it when they get to, like, the funky breakdown. Like, what's about to happen? Let's get it in now, you know?
Yeah. Well, I said at the very beginning that everybody was going to break up, and everybody broke up pretty much in
well,
this
I
episode.
Said.
If they're not broken up this Yo. Episode, they're about to break up in the next one. It happens.
This energy.
Saw it coming.
I can't. I don't know. I still have hope for some of the... I don't... Andrea and Lamar are not broken up. I'm not convinced that they are, but I was really... entertained this episode. Usually I hate watching what's their name?
What?
Josh and Cheryl. Mm-hmm.
As
but
do
this
I.
Was the best
this was
scene
the best one
I've ever watched, including Life After Lockup. Like,
I agree.
Their whole storyline.
I concur.
We might as well just start off with them.
Yeah,
then.
Let's talk about them.
So basically, they just broke up.
Again.
Preferably for the last time. Like, enough already.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just like when Josh was like, split.
We were cracking up. You know, me and Bri usually watch together, and it's always the best when we're on the same page and like literally fall out laughing at the same time. Mm-hmm. So she's going on and on. He's like, why are you still here? What? Take your ass back to Colorado. And all I kept saying, well, first of all, where's her kid? Where the little boy at? Who knows? With her, you never know.
Yeah.
But I was ready for her to go. And the fact that he was so ready was the best. Beat it. Kick rocks. Bye.
I hate him so much. I'm actually Team Cheryl. Just putting that out
what?
There.
I...
I am so disappointed.
I am so disappointed.
Hear me out, guys. I just feel like he finds any reason to dump her. He makes her mad. She responds by being mad. And then he breaks up at her for being mad.
Wait a minute. When does he make her mad?
Like, he was 30 minutes late to the thing. And she's irritated that he's doing that. And then he comes with an attitude.
No.
So she's irritated.
Wait, let her finish.
He came late. She was irritated about that. He comes with an attitude after he's already late, so she gets upset. Then he gets upset that she's upset, so she gets more upset, and then he dumps her. And I feel like that's always their fight is she has an attitude about something that he did, and then he gets mad that she's upset. But either way, arguments shouldn't automatically end in a breakup.
I misunderstood. Are we talking about the same couple? That's only
Cheryl and Josh.
Yeah.
Okay, what? He was 30 minutes late?
He was 30 minutes late.
Yeah, they were going to see a house.
This is my thing, because I put this in my notes. I understand her frustration.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Never in my life will I ever be Team Cheryl. Let me put that out there right now.
Yeah, let's establish that.
But I do understand her frustration. However, I think it just comes down to her delivery. Because I don't think he has a problem with her being annoyed. It's just the way she comes off. Because she's very aggressive in her tone, and she's just always pissy.
Yeah.
And on an everyday basis, she has a pissy attitude.
And it wears
so
on
when
you.
She's mad, she's pissy times two.
Yeah.
So eventually, it's just like, yo, go about your business.
Right. Mm-hmm. Live your life.
Yeah.
My whole thing is all she wants to do is talk about the past and what she's done for him and what she
right.
put in for. Like, enough already, boo. You done did that. We get it. You get all the props, all the points, whatever you want. Let's throw a barbecue, whatever. The point is today, right now, in real life, like IRL, every day you mad. Mm-hmm. And I can't deal with that. I'm a fun, loving, easygoing guy. He pretty go with the flow-ish. Mm-hmm. And all she seems to do is be like, your mama did this. Then you did that. Then the baby. Like, you are mad at everything, girl.
His mom is terrible.
His mom
and
is terrible.
And he never says anything. He's very much a mama's boy. And I think the issue with just their relationship in general and why she'll never have a good relationship with his mom is he's such a mama's boy that every time Cheryl pisses him off, he vents to his mom, which is making his mom not like him. And then Cheryl's getting mad because the mom doesn't like her and she feels like it's for no reason. But it's because Josh is stirring up the issues between the two of them. And then when Cheryl gets mad, he goes off on Cheryl, but he doesn't do the same thing to his mom.
Well, it is his mom, so.
He's a mama's boy, is the issue.
I don't know if I agree. I feel like Cheryl and Tina have the hatred they have because of their own situations with each other. Yeah. I think Josh doesn't do a good job of balancing it out mm-hmm. and telling his mom to chill out. Mm-hmm. And he does only try to chastise Cheryl, which can add on to the animosity. Mm-hmm. But I think, like Josh always says, Cheryl and Tina are the same person, both crazy as hell and very blunt. And I think they naturally will just always bump heads, even if Josh did step in and say, yo, mom, you gotta chill.
Right. Yeah. Even if I think you're absolutely right. And I've been in that position before. It's pretty rough. I mean, I'm not siding with him necessarily. Men really just don't know how to communicate to begin with. So to be able to be like, oh, I have to be the mediator now. Just got out of jail. Like, I'm trying to figure my life out. I have to be stuck in certain situations, including staying in my mom's house. And I'm supposed to know how to navigate and tell you, listen, you do this, you live this life, and you play your position over here. Everybody stay in their own lane. Like I said, I've lived that. Like, I was the girlfriend, and he had the baby mama, and we had so many. It didn't have to go down like that had he been like, listen, you are my girlfriend. This is the role you play. But none of us were old enough to know how to navigate that or, I guess, mature enough or whatever. And clearly, neither are these people. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I think you make a valid point, but he would need some inside help to get
it. I think at the end of the day, by this point, he knows how Cheryl is, and he knows the relationship she has with his mom. So either he can put up with it, and they can stay together, they can stop all these random fights and breakups, or he can just move on. Yeah. Like, at this point, you know this is how she is. So if you continue to get back with her, you're pretty much asking for it, and you can't continue to get mad at her for who she is if you keep taking her back, you know?
And that's why I think he did her a favor by just ending it, because she wasn't going to leave him.
Yeah. Ever.
I think she left her son behind.
That's all I kept saying. Like, we're born yet.
I think she left him behind to give her a reason to go back. You know when you break up and you're like, I left my shirt at your house.
No,
I left my son. I gotta come pick him up.
Oh, that poor baby.
I can
totally
see that. Poor baby.
Oh, gosh. Well, hopefully Cheryl will just learn to just get some anger management or something. Yeah. She really needs the help.
And a couple of cheeseburgers would not hurt, boo, because you look emaciated. Oh, not in a good way.
Oh, God. Okay. Well, we love our fans a little bit more than this. A lot more than that. So, Alexis, let us know. Share this little message.
Hey, guys. So, we just want to say thank you for making us the ESPN of TV talk. We love talking Love After Lockup and our many other shows with you, but we can't continue to do it without y'all doing one thing for us. So make sure, if you're watching on YouTube, to subscribe to our channel if you don't already. Like this video, comment this video as you're watching. If you're listening, make sure to give us a 5-star rating. And no matter what, if it's Love After Lockup or any other show you have here, please continue to come back to AfterBuzz TV, because we can't do this without you.
You guys are the most annoying, like, the most annoying animated
people.
That was
what she had to say. That was everything.
Ridiculous.
I love it.
Lacey and John.
They just drain me.
Yo, Lacey.
It's more Lacey.
Lacey is a finesser.
She is.
When I tell you, she's learned how to get these men under control.
I'm talking about, like, I will do anything, walk in front of moving traffic for you control.
And I love, because it's the exact thing she does with Shane, too. She butters them up to drop the bomb.
Yeah.
And it's a total just mind F.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. And without question.
I want to say I love it.
Because of course you do.
Because I do.
I know you do.
But it's also really
dangerous.
It's very dangerous and unfortunate, because she doesn't even really realize the damage that she's doing to John.
Because she doesn't care. Yeah. She doesn't care.
I don't think
she's... Or her kids.
Yeah.
She doesn't care. It's all about her. Like
the kids.
They're children involved.
Yeah.
Three of them.
I forgot.
And she had the nerve to talk about getting knocked up yet again.
Yeah, like they were just, oh, we love Shane so much.
Yes.
And two episodes later, she's like, well, I don't want to be with him anymore. Like she keeps putting these men into her kids' lives and then taking them away. It's just, if you're not going to not be toxic for your own self, at least do it for the kids.
She's not mature enough to be able to pull that off. I really believe there's a great deal of selfishness with her. She is quite the finesser, quite the manipulator. And when she's ready to flex, that's what she do. She show up. She ain't even got no cutesy, sexy clothes on. She ain't even got to.
Yeah.
She just shows up looking regular, degla, schmegula. Talking about, what up, boo? My bad, I missed it, did you? You out? He gone. You ready? Let's go. Like, she moves all the players on the board and expects everybody to fall in accordingly.
Honestly, I would consider her the goat if the men were actually bringing something to the table. Like,
right,
you have all this
right.
power, but you're using it on people who are, like, drug addicts and have no job.
Nothing.
And that
and
are
keep
in
going
and
back
out of
to jail.
I want to see you move these moves on some people with some money.
Okay.
Who are actually contributing something.
To
like,
society.
You can have all this power you want to, but you're giving it to the local felon down the street. Like, no.
And you got the permanent ink on you. Do you feel like that was, like, the move to kind of stick it
coochie,
to John
y'all.
On her cha-cha?
Now she has to, like, she can't wax or shave anymore. She just got to have it wolfing
Whatever.
All the time.
Not necessarily.
To cover it up.
That's her job, so she doesn't have a choice in that.
I mean, there's a way to tame it together
yeah.
and have it covered, but, like,
right.
that's the dumbest
but
thing.
But is it just, like, across the... Okay, never mind.
I think that she would get off so much on being completely bald and having John feast. And then her being able to be like, yep, looking at Shane's name, looking at John's face.
I wonder if her OnlyFans subscribers don't like it. I wonder, like... Anybody who watches Lacey's OnlyFans things, can you let us know where
yes.
the name is?
Exactly.
Describe it in the
Describe
comments.
Just where it is.
And if you
Put
have
a, diagram
a problem
up.
With it.
You, like, because I don't know. That's a really bold move. And then she told John, you're going to find out eventually. You're
done.
Married.
Excuse me, ma'am? Will he, though? Will he? Clearly, yes. She's a messy, messy, mess, mess,
terrible.
Mess.
Besides the selfish factor of Lacey, I also want to point out the hypocrisy in her.
Girl.
Because she always justifies going back to John because Shane cheated on me and da-da-da-da. But she's literally been a messed up, effed up individual from the very beginning.
From the very beginning.
I'm sorry, like, from love after lockup.
Mm-hmm.
She was engaged to John when she was engaged to Shane. She was seeing John behind Shane's back, communicating with him. But all this other stuff, she still has yet to tell Shane that John is out of jail.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Because she really
out.
Considers herself Queen B. So I think in her mind, it's like, okay, I can do whatever the hell I want, clearly. But what you do, that's what we're going to take issue with. That's what I'm going to have a problem. That's what we need to have, like, a super discussion. Not my kids. not whether or not you're going to, like, be around for a while.
Or she may like that they do that because it gives her a reason to do what she already wants to do.
True.
Like, she's probably like, ooh, this is my moment. He done told me he cheated. Now that's going to justify me cheating back.
That's right.
And then John going to do something else. She'd be like, well, John did this, so I'm about to go do this to Shane. It's like the perfect setup. They just kind of help her, you know?
They
just like, let me do something dumb. Yeah, exactly.
And they never turn their back on her. They never say no to her. It'd be different if they was like, enough is enough. I'm done with you. She probably wouldn't know what to do with herself. Like, now she got to go wash her kids' backs and feed them.
Now I got to be a mom.
Now I got to be a damn mom because these men don't like what I'm giving them. That'll never happen. They love it. They eat it up. You can only be so mad at her. She'll
right.
be mad at them. They're idiots.
Are there any other final thoughts we want to share about Lacey before we move on to our next couple? Because okay.
Okay, what's going on?
I don't know whether to ask her to write a book or to, you know, cut her off my TV.
Right.
I would definitely read any book she wrote because she's so messy.
I want to know about her childhood.
Yeah,
that's a good point.
I would love for her to open up more about her childhood. I feel like that would paint a really good picture of why she is the way she is. I would love to know, where is her mom?
Because her dad is in the picture.
Who was her mother figure growing up?
Mm-hmm.
That would be really interesting to learn. But moving on, we got to learn about Sarah's mom and her family life growing up, and mm-hmm. we saw that her mom actually died when she was 12.
Right.
And it's crazy because it just shows how women are so strong, and our maternal instincts are so strong that even though her mom died at such a young age, she's still able to be such a phenomenal single mother to two kids.
And mm-hmm. she is. She's a great mom.
Yeah, and it just shows you know, there's no excuse for anybody mm-hmm. to be the type of person they are.
Yeah.
Which ties into Michael's story,
yeah. mm-hmm.
who had both of his parents alive.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know, his dad wasn't really there, but he was kind of there,
mm-hmm.
being a gigolo like Michael, mm-hmm. and he's still a shitty dad.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what did you guys think about Michael after hearing his background story?
I think it makes sense. I feel like, you know, he doesn't really know what a father is because he didn't really have a father. His father was there, but he was in and out, which is the exact same thing he's doing. So he's basically just doing what was shown to him. He never really had a full-time dad, so he probably doesn't know how to be a full-time dad. But the same thing you said, you know, Sarah didn't have her mom there a really long time mm-hmm. and was still able to step up and does what she needs to do. So it kind of makes you wonder, okay, is this really what has shaped him to be the way he is, or is he using that as an excuse?
Right.
Yeah. I get the impression he's definitely using that as an excuse. Please forgive me, ladies, but for a split second, I forgot that I'm a feminist, and I was about to go to the default of most women are born maternal. This is what we know. It's in our gut. We're built for this. Whereas men, they've always been given a choice. We live in a society that says you can come and go as you please, as long as you mm-hmm. throw money at it, if you throw money at it. But that's not very feminist of me. That's BS. Because bottom line is, we are built for what we're built for, period.
Yeah.
Male or female, when you have someone else, another human being that relies on you 24/7 for whatever their needs are, you are supposed to be able to put whatever your needs are to the side and make the sacrifices necessary for them to be well-adjusted, mm-hmm. for them to be healthy, happy, and whole. And he refuses to do that. Now, granted, you asked how I felt when that happened. My heart did hurt a little bit for him because I can appreciate that. You know what I mean? If you're in therapy.
For him?
For anybody. For anybody. You know what I mean? I didn't make it about him. I just listened to what he had to say. And mm-hmm. for someone that is in therapy and very grateful to be that way, I can look at what those kinds of revelations do to help you kind of unpack your own stuff and move on, make better decisions. Mm-hmm. So yeah, he's an F up. We already know that, right? Like, mm-hmm. but there's a reason for it. And when you just start doing that, it makes it so much easier for you to like have compassion for these people and try to help them out. He don't want no help, so screw him.
Yeah, but, it's you know. Like you can be an F up, but I don't know if he doesn't know that he's an F up or that he just doesn't want to admit that he's an F up. Because yeah. I honestly really think this man thinks that he's a good father.
He does. That's the impression I get.
And he keeps saying that he's not around because of Sarah, but you're not around because you don't want to be around.
Period.
And you're not putting in any effort. And you know, regardless of whether Mariri was in the hotel room, you still wouldn't have been able to bring your kids there. Not because of Maria, not because of Sarah, but because you are not there for your kids.
Yeah.
Period.
And he like I said, doesn't know it, or he doesn't want to face up to the truth that he's not that guy. You can wear a Aviana and Riley or whatever her name is.
Sweatshirt.
Hoodie. But mm-hmm. all you want to, that'll mean you a good dad.
Not at all.
And that goes right into when the therapist asked, what do you think we can do to improve the communication? And his only answer was, we just let the courts decide and figure it out.
Right.
Before, as a man, you take time to say, what can I do to improve on my side?
He's not a man.
What can I do? Mm-hmm. Just look at yourself and do some type of reflection. He would rather pass the responsibility on to somebody else. So when it doesn't work out in his favor, has somebody else to
blame
why he doesn't have full custody.
And can we not, can we please speak about the fact that Miss Maria is the pastor in his church as well? Like, she's the church of team Michael. Thank mm-hmm. you. And so all she does is sit around and be like, listen, because she's mature, right? She obviously is a little older than
she's
him.
She's old.
And I think that he looks at her as kind of like a mother figure, which is creepy. But the point is, he looks to her for guidance and some type of direction. And she's not short of any direction. But she don't know what she's talking about. You're not in this thing. Oh, there's always three sides, sweetheart. Okay? His side, her side, and the truth. So for you to feel like this is your man because he laid that D and so he should know. Cheryl Bang, you should know as a woman, especially with this age on you, that men don't tell the truth.
Go ahead, Alexis.
I just think it's funny. I just think it's funny how he keeps bringing up, oh, we're going to take it to the court. Like, that's supposed to scare somebody. Like, the court is really going to give these kids to you.
Can we just interject that she already went to the court?
Yeah, and
hello?
I'm so glad she was like, well, that's already been done.
Right.
And I win, you lose. But, like, he keeps throwing this out, like, somebody's supposed to be like, oh, he's going to go to court.
And then
what's going to happen to my kid?
Right. They going to stay with you. That's what's going to happen.
The same thing that happened
what's
when you went.
What's going to happen to my kids?
I have a question, though.
Yeah.
Since Sarah kind of did it backwards, in my opinion, because she went to the courts already, and then she went to therapy, mm-hmm. and then she said this was my last ditch effort. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, shouldn't you have tried the therapy, let it fail, mm-hmm. and then go to the courts for the temporary?
Yeah, in a perfect world.
Okay.
Like, you're dealing with two people that are not only very immature, but have no navigation skills in mm-hmm. this arena. So I think for her, her main concern or fear or whatever was that her kids do not get taken away.
Right.
She's deathly afraid that Michael will just show up, snatch her babies, and be gone. And she'll have no idea where they are, how to reach them, whatever, that they'll be taken care of. So in her mind, it's like, wait, let me secure the bag, which is her babies for her. Thank you, mother. And then it was like, let me follow up by at least giving this man the opportunity to make it right. I think if she thinks that if she did it the other way around, mm-hmm. that he would somehow manipulate the situation, snatch the kids, and then she'd be looking crazy.
He gonna bring them kids right on back because he don't want to be a dad.
He can't handle it.
He's gonna be on the porch by the time she get home from the police office.
They're gonna be sitting there like this.
They're gonna be like, Daddy came.
We've been waiting longer.
I tried to have fun with Daddy and be silly, but it didn't work.
It's so sad.
It is.
Speaking of moms, Carolyn is despicable to me because I see where Michael gets this thing about passing blame on.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
from his mom.
Yeah.
Because when we saw the interaction she had on the phone with Megan and we saw that flashback to
right.
when she said they weren't arguing until
you showed up.
And then Sarah, in her confessional, she's saying, Michael and I argue. That's just what we do.
Mm-hmm.
It's been like that.
It's been like yeah. that from day one.
Forever. And I'm sure Megan is not the first person that Michael has cheated on Sarah with.
Yeah. You know what? But there again, that goes even deeper with the mom. You got to know what her parents were like, right? That
she would even. No.
No, because the advice that she's giving.
Kittie, that woman is too damn old to be talking about, well, what was her parents like? First of all, once you're a mother and you want to play grown up and you give birth to a man and you allow this man to run around and do the same cycle and all that BS, everything you know that he should not be doing, I don't give a hot damn
okay,
and her parents were like.
I kind of disagree, though. Like,
oh, hell.
Honestly,
being an adult does not, unfortunately, take you out of your still... Like, it's 80-year-old adults that still haven't learned what they needed to learn in order to be good parents, babe. I wish it was that simple. Soon as Khalil popped out, I was like, hey, I'm a great parent. I know exactly what
it's
to do.
It's not about being a great parent. It's just a matter of raising your child with certain values.
That's being a great parent.
I thought she was being a good mom in the sense that she is loyal to her son no matter what. Because I know if it was my brother or whenever I have a son, I ain't seen nothing, I ain't hear nothing, he ain't did nothing to her. I ain't got to tell you nothing. I don't
right.
know where my son is.
That's
he can be in the other room. But at the same time, you should be able to do that and still check your
That's
son.
That's my problem.
That's yeah. where she's missing.
That is my problem.
That's a good
yeah.
point.
There's no snitching.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You don't snitch. Mm-hmm. I respect that.
Okay. Yeah.
But I never see her check Michael.
Yeah.
Ever.
She and probably know he ain't gonna pay her ass no attention, so why bother?
Hmm. But I mean, it's still your child.
Still make the
you
effort.
Still do it. You yeah. never at any point you give up and just say, okay, well, throw your hands up and say F it.
Yeah. Some parents, unfortunately, are not good parents.
And
I mean, I'm just saying, like, I'm not trying to throw shade to this lady. I don't know this lady. I don't know this man. But
yeah.
I'm just saying, like, there's different ways of parenting.
And at this point, he's grown.
He is
right.
getting grown. He ain't gonna listen but to so much.
Yeah, so
you know,
I see it from all those sides. But regardless, Michael doesn't know how to take responsibility.
Yeah.
Plus, she allowed the father of Michael to run around and leave and do whatever he was doing, coming in and out of his life, right? So this is a pattern that she's familiar with, and maybe she, in her sick mind, thinks that that's the norm. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It could be. It's mm-hmm. sad, but it
yeah.
could be.
Yeah.
All right. We on sad topics now. Let's talk about Andrea and Lamar.
Lamar, we were rooting for you.
Why you were all rooting? We were all rooting for you.
Okay.
Oh, Lamar.
Okay.
So heavy.
So. Andrea was looking a hot mess.
She was upset.
She was distraught. Like, I've seen Andrea look rough.
Right.
Out of just being depressed or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But this episode really took a toll on me emotionally. Because I saw... Look, when he pulled those condoms out the pocket of his jacket, and before he could even say
anything,
she just laid hands. And yes. I'm like, dang, I feel her.
Yeah, you felt that, didn't you?
I felt her.
She literally leapt across the bed. Like, there was no words that could have made that situation okay. There's not even my... He didn't have nothing coming.
I just wish she would have at least given him, like, a sentence to explain, because it really could have not been that.
Really?
He could have brought them for her because they don't want to have another kid. He could have been holding them for a friend. There's just so many things. Mm. She didn't even give him a chance.
So, Alexis, if your boyfriend came to your house and said, and you found condom in his pocket, and he said, oh, babe, I'm holding those for my homeboy. Right. What is your reaction?
A word. No,
what is your reaction?
I'm going to swing. But I waited until he explained it before I swung. That's what you have to do.
You got to give him a fair chance.
Because at that point, it's not even about the condoms. It's the fact that you're insulting my intelligence.
Ooh, baby.
But he really could have been like, you know, we don't want to have another baby, so I brought some condoms.
He could. And, you know, I was thinking that.
Yeah.
But the moment he said, he basically said mine. They're not mine, mm-hmm. Now it's like, damn, Lamar.
Yeah,
like,
right. Yeah, I got to act you up, Lamar. Sheesh.
So
he's a messy mess, too. Do you believe him? Do you believe him? Do you believe him? Do you believe him?
I don't know.
Oh, no! Look at your face!
That's why I really want her to give him the opportunity to explain what it is. If all we see is her accusing and hitting him and throwing him out and he doesn't even get the chance, how do we know if it's the truth or not?
But can you blame her? Like, they're on different sides of the country.
Exactly. Yeah.
She's been through so much without him, with him.
Hmm.
It's a lot.
It's a lot. Yeah. So I don't care what his sentence would have been. I'm sorry. I don't believe him, and I want to because I love Lamar. He's such a lovable little louse.
As a wife, you have to have some sort of trust in your husband.
Yeah.
To automatically assume the worst means that there's a lack of trust.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not okay in a marriage.
Lamar said it's always some Twilight Zone shit. He's a joke. Like, all right,
I love him.
Let's jump ahead to news and gossip.
Yes, let's. Go, go.
All right, guys. Hello. All right, if you've been keeping up with our show and our News Daily show, then you know Matt Frazier, because this man just will not stop getting arrested. On the last time we reported about him, y'all stop. The last time we had reported about him, he had already been arrested 5 times in 1 year, and I don't understand why they keep letting him out. But they do, and now he got arrested again. He got arrested. You guys, this is a really serious
She said, moment. Why do they keep letting him out?
He's back in jail for driving with a suspended license. He's being held in custody for $2,000 bail. Why they keep allowing this man bail? This is like the 7th time. Just in a span of a year that he's been arrested.
Why is it their responsibility to make sure he doesn't go back out into society?
I don't know. I just feel like...
Justice system.
After a while, like, after arrest number 3, okay, maybe we shouldn't let him out because he's going to keep getting into stuff.
But they can't decide
the
that.
The only thing I can think is that they're trying to get money from all this bail. But regardless, right now it's driving with a suspended license. It was driving under the influence at some point. These are driving offenses. He can hit somebody and kill somebody.
Facts.
So much can happen. Why do you keep letting this man out? But he got arrested again, and so far he's still in there. So, yeah.
It's the picture.
Yeah.
With the story.
Yeah.
It's just too crazy.
Oh, my God. I can't stop coughing. My bad.
Oh, God. Okay. Thank you
perfection.
So much for that, Alexis.
Yes,
that was amazing.
I enjoyed every minute.
Let's jump ahead to this dumb criminal Kitty got.
Yes, let's, shall we? Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. Okay, so this guy, his name is, well, first of all, he's suspected of arson and vandalism. Let's just start there. That's his crime, supposedly. This is in Ohio. His name is Donald Ship Pugh. He texted police after being assuming that, you know, he did this crime, a photo of himself and wrote, "Here's a better photo. That one is terrible."
His mugshot?
His mugshot.
He didn't, okay. So basically he didn't like his mugshot and he sent them a selfie.
There we go, to it say is this is bad. A better picture. So yes, you do look fine in the top picture and look, yes, you do look a bloated, drunken mess in a second, but I don't know that that's probably the smartest thing to do, bro.
So they arrested him for sending him them that?
No. They wanted to speak
to... She told the story backwards.
Oh, okay. I apologize. I said he was, okay, suspicion of, right? They think that he committed armed robbery. Mm-hmm. So it's a suspicion. He's a person of interest. Mm-hmm. And when they brought up a mugshot that they'd already taken from a past visit to them, he said, check this out. Don't use that picture no more, y'all. And then I have no idea how he ended up on a radio station, on a radio show, but he was on a radio station that said, man, they just did me wrong. They put me to put that picture out there, made me look like I was a Thundercat or James Brown on the run. I
not
can't
a Thundercat.
Come on, I can't do that.
That's that uncle jargon.
I don't even
understand. What century is he from?
Why does he feel the need? But that just speaks so, like, you're a narcissist and you're worried about how you look as opposed to the crime. He's an idiot.
He must be a Sagittarius. Well, thank you for our dumb criminal.
Yes, he's a dummy McDum-dum, and I just thought I'd point that out.
Womp womp.
Okay, let's get these predictions going.
AfterBuzz TV predictions.
I have mine.
Go ahead.
So Marcellino and Brittany, we didn't really get too much from this episode, but I think in the next episode, he's going to get caught doing something, but I don't think it's cheating. Mm-hmm. I think he is doing something completely weird and random, like... I don't know, being a magician or something really weird for cash, but I don't think he's cheating.
Yeah.
I think that Andrea and Lamar are going to work it out. I don't think they're going to break up over this. I hope they don't break up over this. I think we're going to see some sort of argument with Maria and Sarah. I don't know if this is a prediction or a hope, but I hope Sarah really digs in her ass. I hope Maria steps up to her, like, thinking she can get her, and Sarah backs her into a corner. Because, honestly, I've been real team Sarah this season. Also, I feel like Megan is only on the show and doing this stuff with Michael so she can get exposure for her singing.
Yeah, people have been accusing them of that for a while.
Because
you've
been out of the picture for a minute, boo. He's not checking for you. You know what it is. You've seen it before.
She hasn't talked to him in 3 weeks.
3 weeks. Yes. Get over yourself.
So I think with her, it's going to be just her singing because that's all that really her storyline is because he don't even want her no more. So
I love the fact that she's writing her lyrics. Talking about me and Michael used to do this together. This was our dream. He was going to rap and I was going to sing the hook. Girl, goodbye.
Crazy in Love remix.
On the run. Literally. Okay, so I definitely see Andrea and Lamar getting it together, making up. I applaud her for sticking to her guns and be like, this is how I feel, and I'm not letting him cross this line, making him stay on the couch. If you're angry, girl, stay, you know, live your best life, whatever. But I know that y'all gonna be all right, because I love them together, and we haven't heard any different, so I'm pretty sure that's gonna be the case. And I really hope that somehow Miss Meth Head gets herself together and comes back to Clint. Because that's just wrong. I mean, she just does him dirty every time. But, like, this man is out of $5,000. Clearly, he don't make no whole lot of coin. For you to just take that man's money and run like that, and you took the dog, that's just adding insult to injury. So I hope that they figure it out in such a way that they can, if they stay together, that they stay together for real and she gets the help she needs. And if they don't, that they walk away amicably.
Okay. I think that Megan is only there because it's going to lead up to a pregnancy thing. Because I think that was like
she had the miscarriage.
Yeah, so that's if there was a real. I don't know. I guess we'll see more detail about that. But I don't know. I feel like this is the end of seeing Cheryl and Josh.
Oh, yeah, I hope so.
I don't see Tracie coming back because I know that I think that was when she first came home was the last time that she taped. Mm. So we're not going to be seeing her. Marcellino, I feel like he's doing something weird, too, for money. Mm. It is Vegas, so.
Yeah. Right. Anything's possible.
That's up in the air. I don't know. I think Lamar... I think Lamar is going to end up at a hotel for the night because Andrea's going to really just be...
She's not having it.
No. I know they're going to get... I know they're going to stay together.
We want them to stay together.
I know they're going to stay together.
Yeah, they're adorbs.
Please do, guys.
Yeah.
And with Michael and Sarah, I don't know. I still feel like Sarah's going to disappoint and not really go in on Maria like how she should.
Oh, are you kidding? That's the
I
one thing.
I don't think Sarah will.
She holds her tongue for some reason with Michael, but when women come into
she
the play...
She did not hold her tongue with
no,
Michael.
No, you're right, you're right. But I mean, I guess on some level, like when she met Megan, oh, she was not the one.
But she was calm.
She was a steely calm. Like, you knew that if she wasn't pregnant, she probably would have jumped up and smacked them.
But Megan also wasn't coming at her with no rah-rah.
Exactly.
Maria and Maria about to come up on some.
Let me tell you something.
I think Maria's going to come with that energy, and Sarah's going to be mad and, like, really emotional, but I can see her crying.
Yeah.
Really?
I can see her crying.
I can see both things.
And that's what you don't, you never let no girl see you cry.
Damn right.
Out of anger.
Especially over no man. You showing weakness, girl. Mm. You better show up in her face.
Sorry. All right.
That's how I feel.
Thank you so much for watching tonight's episode of Love After Lockup here at AfterBuzz TV. You can follow me on Instagram at @IamB_Cheyenne, Chianne. And make sure that you follow our page with our news and gossip all the time, weekly, well, daily, actually. It's at @we.loveafterlockup.
Yeah.
Where can they find
me? My name is Kittie Kaboom. Please find me on IG at KITTIE Kaboom. KABOOM. I have a YouTube page too. I'm going to get it together. Follow me on IG, YouTube. I appreciate it.
And you guys can follow me on all social media at I Am Lexi Fierce. IAMLEXIFIERCE.
Yay! Bye, guys!
Hey. Our founder, Keven Undergaro, and me, Maria Menounos, would like to thank you for tuning in to AfterBuzz TV. Remember, we're not just the first, we're the biggest in the world, and we're the only destination for all your favorite TV shows. Whatever you crave, we've got it. So go to AfterBuzzTV.com and check out our lineup. Buzz you later!
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.